Hello everyone and welcome to Know Your Pharmacist. Myself Harsh Yadav and today I'm going to tell about how to prepare for GPAT examination. Many students query this question that sir, how we are going to prepare for GPAT exam, when we have to start the preparation of GPAT exam and what kind of a strategy it takes to crack this examination. Every year around 45 to 50,000 students appear in this national level examination. Today from 2018, NTA, National Testing Agency, are conducting this CBT exam, that is computer based test, where total 125 questions are going to ask. And if you see the scenario, around 4,000 students got qualified out of 50,000 students. Last time 50,000 students have filled this form and 45,000 students appear on the exam date. So if you see the exam pattern, there is a core subject you have to know about. That is one core subject is pharmaceutics, one is your pharmacognosy, one is your pharmaceutical chemistry, and one is your pharmacology. This is the pure stream in pharmacy which covers the whole pharmacy syllabus. In pharmaceutics, we study the formulation, manufacturing procedure, how to formulate the medicine. In cognosy, we see the origin of medicine, what are the active constituent present in a plant, animal based, marine based, different source, natural source is there. We study in pharmacognosy, and the chemistry is all about in the molecular level. We study SAR, structure activity relationship, and in oncology we see the pathophysiology. We see the pathophysiology and their effect on animal, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4 clinical trials, pharmacodynamic activities are going to study in pharmacology section. So this is the very important subjects which have a broad classification in pharmacy exam. If we see the contribution in 125 questions, we can easily bifurcate them in equal parts. Like if you want to decide in 25 questions, so it is going to be 100 questions, and 25 questions comes others, means different subjects are also there, like microbiology, human anatomy, physiology, jurisprudence, and pharmaceutical drug management, BDSM, drug designing, pharmaceutical analysis, and biochemistry, pharmaceutical chemotherapy. There are so many different other subjects or miscellaneous subjects are also there, which covers around 25 questions. So these are the basic classification for GPAT examination. When you qualify the GPAT exam, this our MHRD gives you 12,400 per month stipend to complete your 2-year course of master degree. 2-year course of your master's degree. If you qualify this exam, this is a very renowned exam in pharmacy professional. For pharmacy professionals, everyone, whether you go for industry, whether you go for any job interview, in academics, in research, in every field, whenever you confront the interview or exam, interviewer, they will definitely ask you about whether you qualified this exam or not. So this kind of things or the stigma is attached to that exam. So it gives you well financial support, as when you qualified your degree exam, you are around 21-22 year of age, so you don't going to be depend on your parents for your higher education. So this is a very much advantage things of GPAT exam. Even for PhD, it is very important, as you are exempted to give any research entrance test when you are qualified GPAD, and it now NTA gives you 3 years validity of this certificate. It gives you 3 years of certificate, so you can utilize when you want to do masters or when you want to do PhD. It will a big opportunity for you to crack this exam. So this is the basic thing. So now we are going to talk about the fear associated with this exam. So first, if you talk about the fear, first, whenever we think about the GPAD exam, we think about the lengthy syllabus. The syllabus is very lengthy. Then second, whether the graduate student wants to do master in pharmacy or not, this is also a very big question. Then third one is your assumption about this exam is very tough. You assume that this exam is very tough. So here I am going to tell you to whenever you think about any exam, never push yourself to target the complete syllabus. Never push yourself to complete the target of covering whole syllabus. The syllabus is like this big circle. This is the syllabus of any exam. And when you attend a regular class in your college or university, it will cover only this portion, because there are many curriculum activities were going on, many things, practical theory class, and many things were going on there. So they cover only this kind of syllabus. So on the basis of this level of preparation, you are knowing never going to be qualified the exam. To qualify any exam, at least you have to push your periphery to that much level. So if you see this concentric circle, you can easily conclude that to complete the or to cover the whole syllabus is not essential. If you clear this gap, you will easily qualify any exam. So this is my concentric strategy to cover any syllabus of any exam.